Okay, hello everyone. So till now we have seen how to make Nyquist plots. So I am expecting you are good in making Nyquist plots. Now what we will do is make use of Nyquist plots. So the reason we make Nyquist plots is we actually define stability. Okay, it's an easier way of defining stability by Nyquist stability criteria. This is given by Nyquist, I guess, who gave a stability criteria n is equal to p minus z, and that is for this contour. For the next contour, for the other contour, I'll give in the next video. This is the formula given. Means Nyquist stability criteria given for this contour, where P is number of poles of GSHS on right hand side of S plane. The number of poles which are on right hand side of S plane, that is what we have to count in place of P. Out of these three variables, we have to find Z. Always we have to find Z, and we will extract from the Nyquist plot. P we will extract from open loop transfer function, and Z we will calculate by this formula. Okay, Z is number of zeros of 1 plus GSHS, or to be more precise, these are the poles of closed loop transfer function, which will tell number of poles of closed loop transfer function, which will tell how many of them are in right hand side of S plane. This also right hand side of S plane, this also right hand side of S plane. Why we are counting on the right hand side of S plane? Because the number of poles we will know for the closed loop transfer function in the right hand side, we can directly say whether the system is stable or not. That's the reason we are looking for right hand side of S plane. This information will not be given to us. This will be given to us by GSHS. And N is the number of encirclement by the Nyquist plot of the point minus 1 plus J0. Okay, why minus 1 plus J0 I will tell later on, but for now just remember, we focus on this point, and we will see in Nyquist plot how many encirclement Nyquist plot is taking of this point. That will be the value of N, plus the sign also we will take, in which direction, either it is clockwise covering the clockwise encircling the this point. In that case we will have this n value negative. If it is covering anti-clockwise direction, we will take it as positive. This is the main thing we have to look at. This will be given to us. If these two are known to us, we can calculate Z, and this formula is for this contour. Okay, this Nyquist stability criteria, we will see examples also. Okay, so this is what it is. So this will be using it. So from now on I won't be making Nyquist plots. I will directly make show you Nyquist plot and test this stability criteria. Okay, because that's the motive. Okay, now if the contour is given in this fashion, anti-clockwise fashion, then the only difference we will have is the relation will be n is equal to z minus p instead of p minus z. So for clockwise side we had p minus z, but for anti-clockwise thing we will have z minus p. Okay, this is the only difference you will see when the contour will change, which is rarely happens. Mostly you will be using the clockwise one and p minus z only. Rest everything is same in this case. Okay, p, the definition of p, definition of z, definition of n, everything will be same. Okay, so we will see how to use it in examples.